My name is Devon Zayas, and I am an artist mainly in photography, where I'm going to be displaying 48 pieces of my photography in the Thomas Crane Library. There's not a name for the exhibit per se, but there is going to be three different stands, all symbolizing a different aspect of what I like to capture, one being urban, the second being wildlife, and then the third being rural. I didn't really get into photography until I met my wife, and she stated that she had a bad memory from remembering things. So that really sparked my interest in saying, okay, let me make sure I go ahead and like capture every moment I can. So it started off by getting a hand-me-down camera from my parents around 3 years ago. And then from there, my wife bought me my first camera on my birthday, like a lot newer model. And then since then, so I've been into photography for the past 3 years. It's more of a, started off as a hobby, but now it's became more of a passion for me, really. It's like I travel everywhere with my camera and try to capture every experience that we go through. What inspires me the most is to be able to capture a moment to be able to reflect on that moment in the future. So, for example, like me and my wife, we will go through the pictures that I take and then really just reminisce in the memory of that moment. Remember the feelings that we felt, the experience itself, what we saw, because it's such one still image, can't really express the whole entire experience, but what it could do is bring you back. So that's the biggest inspiration for me, is really just being able to kind of have something to trace back on, for us to really reminisce about like all the happy times that we've had. Early on in my life, I was always, my father, he loved to draw and paint. My sister's a very good artist herself. So my dad got me into art at a younger age. But for me, my passion for it didn't come until a later age, because although I loved drawing and painting and stuff like that, it was more in either the school setting or doodling in class or whatnot. So it wasn't until recent that I owe a lot of it to my wife, because she has been a major source of inspiration for me, in the sense that she too is a very creative mind. So she'll say, hey, I want to paint. And for me, I wouldn't have thought of wanting to paint if it wasn't for her saying, hey, let's go ahead and paint. And with that, it's the biggest inspiration for me is being able to share what I create. To really have somebody by my side looking at what I create and saying, wow, that's amazing, like, and really kind of cheering me on. She's a major support system for me, and with that, my inspiration kind of grows through, like, with her by my side in a lot of ways. Might sound a little cheesy, but it's something that, it's the truth of the matter, you know? And it's kind of with that, so, the inspiration as a whole for me comes from the love of sharing my creativity. So seeing how it affects other people when they see it. I started with a Canon 4D camera that my parents gave me, and then my wife bought me a Canon T5i, which is a model that's a lot more upgraded than my first one. And it's pretty much, I don't get the same satisfaction I do with taking a picture on my phone as I do with taking a picture on a camera. So that's a big thing for me as well. You'll see on my phone, I don't have very many pictures at all, but on my camera, thousands, all the time. No matter what, I have my backpack, I have three lenses in my camera, and my GoPro always with me wherever I go, no matter what. Even if it's just a simple trip up the road to Marina Bay, which, go figure, is an actual beautiful spot. The photos that will be on display were edited using Photoshop's Element 18. When I do my editing, I try to really maintain the image itself by only doing very minimal, enhancing edits, so that it just makes what the image that already is just pop out a little bit more. Whether it's just a little bit of a color adjustment or a sharpness, but overall, I try to do as minimal editing as I can, because I want the raw, just like, image itself to really stay intact. Prior to really digging into this piece, it's one of those that for me, my photography comes from it's mainly driven through emotion. And so this piece in particular was more of a more feeling down, a little bit of sadness. And what it represents is kind of it's a city at night. You do see the light, so it's, for me, it's pretty much saying, even though I'm feeling down, it's still, I still have that light inside of me. It is dark and it is kind of isolated. There is no people around. It's a very just empty space. It's just, but the lights are still on. So that's what, and this was taken in Boston when I was doing just like walking around the city at night, you know. It's kind of like thinking and just trying to really just bring myself back to a happy place. But during that time, it was kind of, yeah, just, I was experiencing a lot of like lower emotions. And there, for me, this piece, I also want people to understand that it's okay to feel down. It's okay to feel sad. And because at the end of the day, we're still alive, you know, so. That's what this one represents for me. This image was taken at the Cliffs of Moher in Ireland, and this image for me represents pretty much a breath of fresh air. So prior to this image, me and my wife thought it was a good idea to travel the entire country of Ireland. And prior to arriving at this specific destination, we were driving for over 6 hours, trying to like hit, just squeeze the entire country of Ireland into a week, like less than a week. So after just driving for hours, being tired, really not getting the full experience of what we were hoping to get, we arrive here and it was just like a breath of fresh air. When you see these cliffs, it is phenomenal. It's astounding. It's such a beautiful sight. And for both of us, we love being near water. So being able to see the water and then seeing the just like, just the structure of these rocks that were formed, just naturally formed, was, and then on top of it, the sunset was like a perfect addition to it. It was just all just a very peaceful, calming moment for both of us. This piece was on a trip that we took to Hyannis and so we took a trip to the Hyannis and Cape Cod. From there we did do Around the Sound, which is a boat tour that goes from Hyannis to Nantucket, then to Martha's Vineyard and back. This piece was actually taken right before we were about to board back to the mainland in Hyannis. And it was, I love capturing pictures of birds. The biggest reason being is they, to me, they represent the most free. They possess the most freedom out of all living creatures on this earth, in my opinion, because not only can they fly, but they can land on water, they can walk on the ground, they can go wherever they want, when they want. And this image in particular was pretty much, I was lucky enough to capture this where a bird landed pretty much just like it, when you look at it, it looks like they're standing on the water. And that's just, but yet their wings are fully lengthened. So it's like, you know, they're able to fly, but they're walking on water. And it was just, birds have always been something to me. My grandmother, rest her soul, she was very big into birds. She got me my first bird when I was a little child. And since then I've just been infatuated with them because of what they represent to me. The advice I would give other artists and photographers would be never dream too small. Always be true to yourself in the sense that nobody should have the power to say that your art isn't good enough. And it all stems from believing in yourself first. And it helps having somebody to believe in you too, but trying to find that true inner inspiration and keep that. Because in this world where we're surrounded by so many things and so many opinions, of course there's gonna be bad ones. But there's also gonna be good ones. But neither side should really matter. What should matter the most is what you feel that your art brings. To exhibit at the Thomas Crane Library is, in a way, a dream come true for me. And it's like, again, I'm gonna sound like a broken record with this, but it wasn't until my wife was like, your photography is good enough, you should really pursue it, that I started believing it myself. And to now be sitting here at the Thomas Crane Library getting ready to display my photography is such a, it's a blessing in a lot of ways. Because I never thought once that, other than in like high school where I had a painting hanging in just a corridor, but I never thought that I would be here displaying art for the public. One of the biggest things I would like people to get from my exhibit and my displays is to really see that creativity, we are all born with a sense of creativity, and it's really in the eye of the beholder of what creativity is and what art is, but to really understand that art is something that we should all really cherish, and to really, for my photography, I would like people to really get a sense of like, wow, like a wow factor is like, these are amazing sights, and kind of, in a sense, feel what I felt when I took the picture. And in doing so, the photos I chose, I tried to make sure that they were the ones that really grasped the eye, to really say like, that is a really cool photo. I wonder what that experience behind it is.